Okay, well, some interesting news. This car has been used for work for 1 week. The car, my other car, the Camry, actually broke down at the service station, and I happened to use the mechanic services at that same business. So the other car broke down where my mechanic is, and so I've had to use this car to get to work. And I happened to finish the work the day before I needed to use it for work. So what I can report after 1 week is the alternator, of course. The alternator belt had to be adjusted because it got some slack in it. And now I've drained the water. Of course, I didn't put water in it. I used this radiator and battery, we'll call it water or solution, and I put some rust inhibitor in it because I've probably said it before in this video that when there's no water in the system, because it's probably an iron block, it does rust out. And there's the water, so it's definitely a good idea to give it a flush. And now I'll put the coolant in. Okay, so now I'll put the coolant in. I used to be able to use 100% undiluted coolant. But these days it's unaffordable. So whether you think it's a good idea to use 100% undiluted coolant or not, these days that's really all I can afford, or all I can, the only money that I can justify, put it that way. So that'll go in. I have to put the grill on next. I have to put some protective cover over this join. That probably cost me $4,000 because the horn didn't work, but that's a very, very involved and complicated story. I won't go there now. So yeah, just the coolant and the grill, and this work is a success. Okay, so to fill it up, I filled up the radiator and the reserve bottle. It didn't take all that much more, so. So that's how much I've used so far, 1.5 of these 5-litre bottles. So they're either out of date or they're 3 months old. I'm just about to time the engine. Newer engines aren't really timed anymore, but just to explain, this is the timing gun. Light will come out of the end of it in pulses. It's hooked up to this number one or front spark plug lead. Okay, so we've got a ground and an earth, and the light's hooked up to that. Okay. So there's two. We've got these marks down here. You might be able to see 1, 2, 3, and there's the mark on the. This will turn. That will turn around and line up. We probably want. I'm not really sure, but I'm probably going to line it up with the middle mark there. Now, to time it, or to get that mark to walk forward or back on that those timing marks, we have to undo that nut there. This is the distributor. And there's a lock-in nut there. We have to undo that. And we actually rotate this to get the timing right. So now that it's loose, I'll just show that you can actually turn this a bit. Okay. And that's what I'll be doing to do the timing. I'm going to close the door because it does have to be dark in this area. Okay, at this point I have backed off this pinch bolt. I've removed the plug and you can see my finger passes through that point. There's a bolt in there. If you loosen that bolt off, you know, a bit, but not too much that the bolt falls out. Just loosen it off a bit. There's a high spring tensioner in there that will put more tension on your timing belt, so your timing belt goes up there and down, and there's a tensioner here. If you undo this nut here, not too far, then it'll tighten your timing belt, and I've done that now. So I've loosened this bolt off, I've tightened it up, and then tightened up this pinch bolt, and now I'll put the plug in the back in the hole. That's it. And I undid the spring tension bolt with this. It looks like a 12 millimeter. And I worked down there in this direction, not that direction. You will find with this type of setup, you will find a little bit of room between there, working that way. Okay, so I think that's the safety zone there. It is in the middle of the timing mark, so I'll buy that.